Hey guys, it's Tommy here, the Flying Chinese Guy. Today I will give you a basic tutorial for Infinite Flight Solo. Please leave a like for this video, and if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask on the comment below. And now let's get started. First, to start the game, tap on the Flight Solo button on the game, and choose your favorite aircraft, departing airport, and the time and weather, and tap on the flight button to start the game. And please be advised that most of the planes and regions are paid. I'm bored, guys. So today I will teach you how to read the HUD properly. Now in the front of us is the HUD. On the left is a speed belt, which shows the indicated airspeed, and below shows the ground speed, Mach number, and the wind information. And there's the map. The white plane logo shows where you are. Now on the right is the altitude belt, which shows your current and means sea level measured altitude, and the number below is the rate of ascent or descent. Well, IOS for GPS approaches, the glide slope will be active and work with the localizer to help you approach. On the middle down part is the electronic compass, which shows your current heading, your selected heading, and your localizer will be shown while GPS or IOS approach, and it will work, and I will talk about it in another video. Now let's focus on the center top. It's the roll indicator, which indicates the bank angle, and next down there will be the pitch ladder showing you the angle of attack. In the middle, it indicates your plane's pitch, roll, and real nose angle. Below there will be a bird-like thing called the vector indicator. It will show you the flight path, and this is how you read HUD properly. And this is today's tutorial. Thanks you guys for watching, and don't forget to follow my Instagram and subscribe my channel for more videos.